Hello students, welcome to the session on cold bath. This is described in rational hydrotherapy in the chapter hygienic measures or prophylactic measures. So usually the cold bath is not considered as one of the hydrotherapy treatment as such. It is considered as routine, but still in hydrotherapy cold bath is considered as a powerful tonic agent. So whenever we go for cold application all over the body, so generalized cold application will have excitant effect. So it improves the general vital resistance, thereby it increases the activity of the all organs in the body. So it is considered as a powerful excitant and tonic. It acts on sympathetic nervous system. So there will be vasoconstriction all over the body. So sudden cold application, many times it will be very unpleasant. So here the unpleasant effect is because of the sudden vasoconstriction over the body. So the action of the cold is on the sympathetic nervous system as such. And whenever there is vasoconstriction over the surface, there will be vasodilatation in the inner part. So the organs will be stimulated, the activity in the organ will be enhanced. That is how it becomes a tonic. So whenever there is increased activity in the organ, so it maintains the nutrition for the organ and it helps for the elimination from that particular organ. So that is how this is a cascade of the responses which is being produced by the cold bath. Vasoconstriction in the surface, vasodilatation in the inner part, stimulation of the activity in the organs, resulting in improved nutrition and eliminatory function in the body. So later, after some time, maybe after 5 minutes or so, after the action period is over, the cold application results in the vasodilatation over the skin as such, because the secondary response of the cold is vasodilatation. So it the action period is over, so body enters into the reaction phase, so there will be increased surface circulation. So that is how we can just have the stimulation of the inner organs as well as stimulation of the skin by the cold bath. So that is the double benefit which we can just get by the cold bath alone. Now, if we discuss about the cold bath in children. So Kellogg says below 7 years of age, cold treatments are to be avoided, because whenever we give cold application, children cannot tolerate the cold temperature as such. You know that there is no proper development of the heat regulatory centers in children below 7 years of age. So response for the cold application and hot applications are, you know, very, very slow. That is why below 7 years of age, cold bath is not preferred. Then here cold bath, I mean cold application in the form of douches or frictions or immersion bath are also should be avoided in people, in children below 7 years of age. You may be knowing that whenever Curie says about antipyretic effects, he says that there should be a sudden dip of the child in a cold water and you should just take out the child very immediately. So purpose is to decrease the heat production in the body and to increase the heat elimination in the body, and that can be done just by a sudden dip, not by keeping the child in the cold water. So whenever there is decrease in the heat production and increased heat elimination, there will be treatment of fever. So Curie prescribes sudden dip in cold water for children below 7 years of age. He doesn't prescribe the cold bath as such. Okay, so it sudden dip has the antipyretic effect. So children who are suffering with the rickets also can be given this particular treatment, because whenever body is being dipped in the cold water, the sudden dip helps in improving the nutrition inside the body, and it overcomes the malnutrition. So in rickets, we can just see that cold dip can help. And in children above 7 years of age, we can just lower the temperature up to 72 to 75 degree Fahrenheit. So higher temperatures of cold can be given in children who are above 7 years of age. And here effusion and light douches can also be given in the same temperature. In children above 14 years, we can just adopt for lesser temperatures of cold. So temperature can be lesser than 70 degree Fahrenheit. Then cold douches can be given, and effusion can also be given in lesser temperatures of cold. Usually in children above 7 years and below 14 years, when cold bath is given, it helps to relieve the urinary incontinence, if any. Now coming to the cold bath for adults, the prescription of cold bath for adults, it depends upon the healthy condition of the person as such. If person is having atherosclerosis, cold bath should be avoided. Then 3 to 4 minutes of hot bath can be followed by the cold bath in a person who is very sensitive for the cold. And 68 to 80 degree Fahrenheit of temperature can be given for adults. And person who is having sedentary lifestyle, for him cold bath will be very, very beneficial. It can be given along with the friction. So 3 to 4 minutes of friction should be given before the cold bath. Many times the cold bath can also be followed by the sweating procedures. So after steam or sauna, cold bath is very, very compulsory. So it can be adopted in adults between 18 to 65 years very comfortably, whenever person is, not having any other morbid condition like cardiac disorders or kidney disorders. So whenever person is hale and healthy, we can just go for cold bath without any doubt, at the temperature below 70 degree Fahrenheit very comfortably, or even in lesser temperatures of cold. So cold can be given in the form of effusion, douche or immersion for these groups. If patient is very weak, in the sense if person is having asthma or chronic kidney disease, or if he is having cardiomegaly, or if he is having severe or morbid hypertension, then whenever we administer the cold, precaution has to be taken. We can just go for gradual immersion of the body part by part, and we can also prescribe higher temperatures of cold in the beginning, or we can also go for partial applications like in the form of packs or compresses before the cold bath. These are all the precautions which we need to take whenever we just go for cold bath in adults. So that's about today's topic. Thank you.